My name is Jenny Alcorn. I'm the coach of the Surfers Paradise Triathlon Club. I live here in Surfers Paradise at Miami, and I'm 57 years old, and primarily I'm a triathlete. Originally an age group athlete coming through, then spending 20 years as a coach, and now I've decided that I want to fulfill some of my own personal dreams with respect to what I can achieve. And for me, that's a progression to hold my club together and hopefully a mentor for a lot of athletes that I coach along the way. I love the feeling of the support network that each one of my athletes has for the other athletes in my squad. I love the discipline, I love the motivation, I love the respect they have for me and that I have for them, and I love the camaraderie of the squad. And that's probably one of the most important things about triathlon, because after that, if I can get people to come to training because they love it, I know that they are always going to improve, because the sessions that we have, they have purpose, there's challenge, there's skill, there's technique involved, and there's grit and there's hard work involved. And that's for everyone on all levels, you know. Not everyone wants to be a champion, you know. People come out here and they just want to be able to say, I've done better at this and I've done better at this and I can improve and I'm really enjoying it. Midway 2014, I decided that it was time for me to come back out of, you know, pull out my bike and pull out my gear and actually do something competitive for myself. And I can always remember telling my athletes for years and years and years that I was never going to do an Ironman. It's not me, I'm not going to do an Ironman. And then, you know, I turned 55 and something just clicked in my head and I went, yep, I want to do an Ironman. So I went and did my first Ironman at Busselton. And I was, firstly, I just loved the training so much to get myself there. And so did my athletes, so did my squad. Went to Busso and won my age group. And you know, it was a hard event, but got through it, and that literally first up gave me a qualifying spot for Kona. It was 10 months before Kona came back around in 2015. So literally got all through my training, and within 10 weeks of getting to Kona, I had a major accident, of which, you know, I broke my collarbone, I had 3 broken ribs, I broke my wrist in 2 places, broke a few fingers, and was fairly much beat up. And that was the end of my pursuit for Kona. But being the athlete I am and being the woman I am that wasn't going to really let anything affect me, I pretty much as I could, got back into my coaching straight away. I was walking around with my arm in a sling. I made it to all my sessions. I had someone drive me through the bike sessions. I coached on pool deck. And for me, I worked really, really hard on my recovery. And probably the one thing I worked even harder on was my mental and emotional ability to be able to, you know, cope with the trauma of your lifetime dream, making it to Kona, and then knew you couldn't go. And I was pretty proud of myself, and in the end, it actually wasn't that difficult for me to accept that I wasn't going to be able to race. I watched the race, but also obviously while I was there, I had a look at what the course was like. I knew what was in store for me, and I was determined that I was going to get back there. So literally, I spent the next 12 months rehabbing and getting fit, going to Cairns, qualifying Cairns, and then competing in 2016, which is when I won. So I finally got there. I won the world champs in Kona in 2016, just recently passed, which a lot of people kind of said to me, wow, that's just amazing. You did that the first time. It doesn't usually happen. So it's kind of funny for me, you know, like I've ticked off my goal and I've kind of moved on. I've got one more goal that I want to achieve, and that's literally to get myself back to Kona and in my mind, I felt like I was running scared that whole race in Kona. I had someone chasing me the whole race. The former world champion was chasing me the whole race. And I didn't actually enjoy the event because I was so stressed about it. I want to be able to go back now and actually compete in it, knowing what I know about the course now, and also just giving myself another 12 months training behind myself, of which already I can feel the difference in, you know, physically where I'm at. And that's probably something I like to tell everyone a lot about, because I'm 58 now, and for me at 58, coming through, you know, with a triathlon background and then coming back into competing, I just want to really let everyone know, especially, you know, people that are in that category 40 plus, that you can always improve. You know, like, if you really want to achieve something and if you really want to work on it and you really want to challenge yourself, or you want to challenge your ability to be able to learn and focus. To this day, I still have that deep down competitiveness in me, and I think that that's going to go on for as long as I'm doing what I'm doing, and as far as I can see, that's just it's my life, and that's what I'll be doing, and I'm looking forward to it still. I look forward to getting up every single morning to go to my sessions. I never miss a session. I do 7 mornings a week. A few afternoons, got personal training sessions. I'm just so motivated, and because people motivate me, you know, like a lot of people say I motivate them, but I'm actually motivated by their enthusiasm and their want to learn and their want to improve. And it's almost beyond triathlon, what I feel. It's just opening someone's shell out and then putting them into this new world and them discovering something new and something different that's going to give them more self-worth, it's going to give them more confidence to go out and achieve in other areas in their life. That's what I love about this sport.